بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد كان لسبأ في مسكنهم آية صدق الله العظيم وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الدين النصيعة أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم Respected ulama ikram, respected brothers and elders, praise and thanks is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His infinite mercy and grace, His love, His kindness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has showered us with so much of blessings and bounties that it is impossible for insan to count the bounties that Allah ta'ala has given us. Every bounty of Allah ta'ala is precious. Every gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not a gift in one, but rather it is numerous gifts hidden in every gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah give us the ability to thank Allah ta'ala, to appreciate the bounties that Allah has given us. And the greatest that Allah has given us is Allah has given us iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this great gift in believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is that only gift that will benefit a person forever and forever. Benefit a person in dunya, benefit a person in qabr, in akhirat, forever and forever. So we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve our iman. May Allah give us the ability to live a life of iman. When maut come to us, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us maut upon iman. And on the day of qiyamah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect us with the people of iman. Allah Pak has given us Quran, which is also a great blessing. And Quran is a means of guidance for us. Allah ta'ala has revealed the Quran so that this insan throughout his life, he can be guided through the teachings of Quran and he can reach where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants him to reach. Now we will find as far as Quran is concerned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as far as Quran is concerned, it's a very concise kitab. It's a very brief kitab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not go in too much detail in Quran. Quran is a book of principles. It's a book, it's a kitab, whereby briefly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions things. For example, if you look at the laws of Allah ta'ala, the ahkam, whether it is the law of salat, whether it is the law of zakat, etc., a brief commandment of Allah ta'ala is given in Quran. Aqimu salah, establish salah, wa atu zakat, pay your zakat. But the finer details with regards to this year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had left it to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to explain the ummah. And Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam throughout his life practically demonstrated salat. One of the commands of Allah ta'ala established salat. But Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through his actions showed practically the sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum how to perform salat. And then he left them with this rule, he left them with this command, صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأِيْتُمُونِي وَصَلِّي. That perform salat as you've seen me performing salat. Like this, with regards to zakat, if you will study the entire Quran, you will not find with regards to how much of zakat should be discharged, etc. The minor, the details with regards to that has been given to us by Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned a brief ayat in Quran, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. That whatever the Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you, you should hold firmly onto it, hold steadfastly onto it. And whatever Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibits you from, you should stay away from it. So a person should not think that Quran is just sufficient, there's no need for the sunnah. The sunnah is explanation of Quran. So on one hand, Quran being a very brief, concise kitab, but on the other hand, we will see that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the past nations, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes into some detail. For example, if you look, Allah ta'ala speaks about Musa alayhi salatu wasalam in Bani Israel. Allah does not mention about Musa alayhi salam in Bani Israel in one place in the Quran. But in 29 paras of the Quran out of 30, Allah ta'ala has mentioned in various places the various incidents of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam in Bani Israel. So when it coming to the past, the events of the past, the events of the people of the past nations, Allah Ta'ala goes into detail. Now what's the purpose for this? The purpose for this is that Quran is not a storybook. It's not in which Allah has mentioned some stories so that we read it to the children so they can fall off to sleep at a time when they're going to bed. But actually, these stories are not to put anybody to sleep, but these stories are to wake us up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Yet in the narratives and in the stories which Allah ta'ala has mentioned in Quran, it is actually a means of ibrat, it's a means of lesson for the ummah of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So in every incident that Allah has mentioned in Quran, there's some principle that Allah is mentioning. And that principle, it is for me and you to look at ourselves. And we have to look into the mirror of those incidents and see whether those things affect our life or not. That what was the downfall of the people of the past, if we as the ummah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will carry out the same things, then this will invite also our downfall as well. So that is why Quran is something that daily we should reflect on Quran. One is alhamdulillah, the tilawat of Quran, which is very, very important. We are in the Mubarak months, Rajab, Sha'ban, close to Ramadan. Let us not wait for Ramadan to open the Quran. Let us start from now, every day after every salat, little bit of Quran we recite. Not only let us recite Quran, let us better our recitation of Quran. Alhamdulillah, in our masjid here, we have qurra, we have ulama who can read the Quran very beautifully. Let us learn the Quran. Then with regards to the meaning of Quran, let us reflect on the meaning of Quran, but not on our own. Let us not attempt on our own through some social media site or something, or some YouTube site or something, and we're following some person on tafsir. No. To learn the tafsir of Quran, the meaning of Quran, this year we need the ulama also. So let us daily reflect on Quran and take the message of Quran. So Allah Ta'ala mentions in Quran, لَقَدْ قَانَ لِسَبَئٍ فِي مَسْكَنِهِمْ آيَةٍ. Allah Ta'ala mentions about the people of Saba. And Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala says that in the dwellings of the people of Saba, there is an ayah, there is a sign for you. A sign for you to take lesson. There is some incident that Allah has mentioned for you to reflect and take lesson. The people of Saba were the people that resided in the area of Yemen, of today's time Yemen. They resided in that area. Allah Ta'ala, for their guidance, Allah Ta'ala sent many Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. Among the famous Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, Sulaiman alayhi salam, Dawud alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah Ta'ala sent to the people of Saba. Now as far as the people of Saba is concerned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed them with many, many bounties, many, many gifts. Jannatani ayyamini wa shimal, kulu min rizqi rabbikum wa shkuru lah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it such that the town was here on the two sides of the town, beautiful gardens, lush. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had bestowed them. All types of what you can so say luxuries, Allah ta'ala had given it to them. To such an extent, the ulama have mentioned that so much of fruit Allah has given them that if a woman would walk through that orchard with a basket on her head, automatically the basket would get filled with the fruit. There was no need for any effort to pluck the fruit. So much of abundance Allah ta'ala had given them. But the command of Allah Ta'ala was, "Kulu min rizqi rabbikum," eat of the provisions of your sustainer, and washkuru lah. The commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was, make shukr, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, appreciate it. Now, respected brothers, when we come to shukr, our understanding is very limited. That when we come to shukr, we think that only shukr is to express with the tongue. I said, Alhamdulillah, I have showed shukr. The verbal utterance of appreciation is only the start of shukr. It's only the beginning of shukr. That it's necessary for a person that he has to thank Allah Ta'ala. Whatever Allah Ta'ala has given a person, he has to thank Allah Ta'ala verbally. But that's not the end of shukr. That's only the start. The essence of shukr is that every bounty of Allah Ta'ala, whatever Allah Ta'ala has given us, firstly, to acknowledge and to understand from the recesses of our heart, that this is from Allah Ta'ala. It's not my achievement. It's not my, that I am worthy of it. This is that I have the right for it. No. Allah in His mercy, Allah in His love, Allah in His kindness, Allah has given us. Whatever I am enjoying, my hands, my legs, my sight, my ears, whatever it may be, whether it's the wealth Allah has given in the car that I'm driving, whether it's the wealth, whether it's the house, it's not that I deserve it. Allah in His mercy, Allah has given it. So the first thing to appreciate it from the heart, to understand it and acknowledge it, that this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Going further, what is shukr? Is to use every bounty of Allah Ta'ala how Allah Ta'ala wants us to use it. If a person uses, for example, a person comes, gives you a very, very smart pen, and now you use that pen with a hammer on the wall to knock the wall. That is showing naqadri, that is showing this ingratitude. You're not appreciating that bounty. So Allah has given us so many bounties. We have to use every bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a servant, as a slave of Allah ta'ala. Allah has given us our eyes. We cannot just use our eyes how we want to. There are certain commandments, there are injunctions, how to look after our eyes. We have to see that we have to see those things which Allah wants us to see, not those things which Allah ta'ala has prohibited us. Like just every other bounty that Allah ta'ala has given us. Yet we are the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And a servant, don't question. A servant is the one who submits. That whatever is the hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever is the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if Allah ta'ala has commanded me that I should use this bounty in this particular manner, I will use it as such. If Allah ta'ala has refrained me from doing a certain thing, I will not even go one step forward. I will not try to interpret the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to suit my fancies and to suit myself. And this we learn from the life of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, the pinnacle of abdiyat, of showing himself as the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that falamma aslama wa tallahu lil jabin, when Allah ta'ala commanded him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him that he must slaughter his son Ismail alayhi salam. There was no second question that why he's so young, after so long I've got a child, what's the need for it? He's so I can slaughter an animal. They both submitted to the hukum of Allah ta'ala. This is what is needed, that we have to become the abd of Allah. We have to submit. It's easy to say the story of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, but are we ready to put a knife on every evil in our life? Are we ready to cut out some sort of sin from our life? That bribery and corruption that we involve in, are we ready to put a stop to it? Are we ready to put those mixed gatherings that we get involved in, which breaks the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are we ready to take it out of our lives? That incorrect income that we are achieving through interest, etc. Are we ready to put a knife on it and to turn it out of our lives? So this is what is required. That we, the essence of shukr, is we have to become the true servants of Allah ta'ala, the true abd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That we will not question whatever Allah has commanded us. We will 100% comply to the command of Allah ta'ala. If Allah ta'ala has said in the law of inheritance that the male will get a double share than the female, we will not question Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah ta'ala has said that interest is haram, we will submit and we will make sure in every dealing of ours, we will not get involved in interest. So this was the command of Allah ta'ala to the people of Sabah. Washkuru lah. Show gratitude to the commandments, show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But these people, instead of showing gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fa'a'aradhu, they turned away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They turned away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what would happen is that Allah ta'ala used to send abundant rain for them. And when the rain used to come, it used to cause floods. So what they used to do, they built a dam wall. So this used to block the water from coming and destroying, what's it called, their crops, their plantations and their cities. So what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent, when they turned away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent one of his makhluk, one of his creation. And when Allah ta'ala wants to destroy someone, Allah don't need big things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent two blind mice. And these two blind mice, they started to eat on the inside of this wall, causing the wall to become hollow. And then when the floods used to come, when the rain started to come, that wall was too weak. And then the wall gave in. And what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused the wall to give in. And what happened? The water came, the floods came, and destroyed the entire cities of the people of Sabah. What was beautiful gardens, lush gardens, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made those gardens, changed it into such gardens that was giving, which was thorny gardens, such fruit like tamarisk, bad smelling fruit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused to grow in those gardens. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذَلِكَ جَزَيْنَاهُمْ بِمَا كَفَرُوا وَهَلْ نُجَازِ إِلَّا الْكَفُورِ. That this is the principle Allah is mentioning. This is that point that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning. That this which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a punishment on the people of Sabah, it is not confined to them. That's what Allah Ta'ala sent is for the ummah of Sayyidina Rasulullah SAW to reflect that if you will show naqadri, if you will show ingratitude to the bounty of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, then inna azabi la shadid. You should remember that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala's usul and Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala's way of dealing is that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will send his azab, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will send his punishment. But remember, when Allah Ta'ala will send a condition on the ummah, it is actually to wake us up. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will send us conditions to wake us up. Like Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala does not need a big creation to send an azab. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will make it. Some microscopic virus will come where the whole world will come to a standstill. These things don't just come like that. It comes because of the amal of this ummah. Allah Ta'ala says, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِي النَّاسِ لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Allah wants us to return back to Him. Allah will send these conditions to test us. Almost a year, respected brothers and elders, we are going through this condition. If a person's eyes don't open up, if a person does not reflect, if a person don't understand that Qiyamah is near, if a person don't understand that Maut is near, then respected brothers and elders, it's a pity on a person. We have to reflect. Let us ponder how much Allah has given us. What system Allah has given us as far as deen is concerned. Look at our makatib system. Look at our madrasa system. Look at our masajid. Look at our darul ulums. Look at our ulama. What we have got in this country, what Allah has given us, very few even of the Arab countries are deprived of this year. So what is the demand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants? That we should appreciate it and show shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When sin will come prevalent in the ummah, when things like bare hayai, immodesty, when these things will come prevalent in the ummah, then Allah Ta'ala will send conditions on the ummah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressing the muhajirin and said that, O muhajirin, khamsun idha tulitum bihinna wa a'udhu billahi an tudrikuhunna, that there are five things, that if you are afflicted with these five things, and I am seeking protection and Allah Ta'ala protect you. Allah protected the sahaba day when they obeyed the commandments of Allah Ta'ala. But among the things that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that will cause which will bring the adab of Allah on this ummah, the first number one which Allah Ta'ala with Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, لَمْ تَظْهَرِ الْفَاحِشَةُ فِي قَوْمٍ قَطُّ حَتَّى يُعْلِنُوا بِهَا إِلَّا فَشَى فِيهِمَ الطَّاعُونَ وَالْأَوْجَاعُ الَّتِي لَمْ تَكُنْ مَضَتْ فِي أَصْلَافِكُمْ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it when immodesty, when immorality will come prevalent in the society. Not just like that, it will become open. Today, my respected brothers and elders, how much of immodesty there is. In the past, a person wanted to see something evil, he would go quietly in the room under his blanket, he would see something wrong. Today, on the touch of the button, how much of evil is on the phone? What different evil, pornography, etc. Not only that, today in our school systems, they are legalizing this education to teach children at the age of grade 4, a youngster, is not even 11 years old, but it becomes compulsive upon him to understand this year, to learn this year. Not only that, such education that a person, he can choose what gender he wants to be. When this immorality will come prevalent in the ummah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, such type of sicknesses, such type of plagues will afflict this ummah that we never even heard of these things in the past. Your predecessors never heard of such things. Wherever did we hear of such a virus, such a sickness, such a thing like this here? All this is the result of the amal of this ummah. But there is no need for us to lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to turn back, make tawbah unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, appreciate the bounties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, prepare every day to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, appreciate what we have. And when we will do this year, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless us. In our masajid, we have ulama, sitting the gatherings. We have ta'aleem that takes place in the masjid, sitting the ta'aleem. Establish ta'aleem in our homes. Sit with the kitab, have fazail ta'aleem. Sit with that. Why? This will bring nur in our homes. This will protect our aqidah. This will protect our deen. This will make us to appreciate the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that gifts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward us. May Allah ta'ala accept us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the tawfiq to appreciate every bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whatever we have heard, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to pass on to others so this can remain fresh in our lives. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.